Okay, so as you listen to this story, just take a moment to close your eyes, allow yourself to get comfortable, and begin to relax. And I don't know whether you'll drift off asleep faster with the spaces between my words or with the sound of my words. And as you listen to me talk in the background, so you can relax and drift asleep. So this is a story about a woman who's traveling across the Arctic. It's something that she's always wanted to do. She's always seen it as something that would challenge her, something that would give her a sense of accomplishment. And she also liked the idea of being out in nature. She liked the idea of being able to see the northern lights. And to test her abilities. So as this woman was traveling, and so one morning, this woman woke up in her tent, and she could hear the sides of the tent flapping and vibrating in the wind. She could hear the sound of that wind outside the tent. She could notice the way the snow was packed up partway up the side of the tent. While she lay in that tent in a sleeping bag, wrapped up so comfortable, so warm, with the light just right, illuminating that tent as the sun shines through the tent. And after getting ready for the morning, she opens the tent, pushes out through the snow, walks out into that snow. She clears the snow away from in front of the tent, builds the snow up a little bit around the edge, stopping the wind from blowing directly into the tent, creating a wall of snow, directing that wind up and over the tent. And she has a special camping stove which she uses to make herself some food and have a warm drink as she relaxes in the entrance to the tent, enjoying that food and drink before clearing everything away, packing it all away, ready to continue her journey. And she packs it all away, puts it on the back of a trailer being towed by the snowmobile, gets on to that snowmobile, and travels following the compass in the direction she's heading. And as she heads along, so she notices that out here, most of what she sees around her is just snow in whatever direction she looks. It was a few days earlier where she last passed trees. And she often finds herself thinking back to the pine forests, to how much calmer the wind was back then. But she's aware that she's making this journey to achieve something for herself. And she's doing this journey on her own, but a few times every day, she uses a satellite phone to contact people, let them know her progress, let them know she's okay. She also has GPS tracker on her and knows that people can monitor her on their computers. They can see where she is, what progress she's making. They can monitor the weather. They can give her updates as she needs them. And as she continues traveling, so she plans on going straight through the North Pole and then straight over to go the other side. And most of her journey is made on this snowmobile. And so she continues her journey, crossing that snow. And currently, the sun doesn't stay up. And as she crosses that snow, so she thinks about the journey she's had so far. She thinks about other experiences. She often finds herself thinking about being with friends in coffee shops, thinking about wandering around parks, thinking about quite mundane things that she's missing out on while she's out here, things which, when everything is just so white and plain, she happens to end up missing. Things she never would have thought of missing, and never would have necessarily said if someone said, "What would you miss if you went traveling?" And as she continues, so the sun begins to set again. And she's been traveling for many hours. And as the sun sets, so she sets up camp again. She sets up a tent. And she packs some snow around the tent to help insulate the tent. And she faces the entrance to the tent, the opposite direction to the wind. And she goes into her tent. She's surprised at how quiet it is when she enters the tent. And that she gets so used to the volume of the wind, of all the sounds outside, that she's traveling along thinking that it's quiet because there's nothing around. And yet, actually, there's a lot of noise given off. And you only notice that difference when you change environments. You get so used to one thing that you stop noticing it. And she relaxes down in that tent. And before she closes the tent and settles down fully, she makes herself some food, some drink on her stove. She then closes that tent, lies back wrapped up in a sleeping bag, closes her eyes and just listens to the sound. The sound of the wind on the tent. And after a little while, still wrapped in her sleeping bag. The sun has long set, and so she decides just to have a peek out at the northern lights. She opens the tent a little bit and gazes out and up the lights in the sky, the sight of the occasional shooting star, and she notices how the wind has really died down now, how everything seems so calm, so relaxed, almost like you could probably hear a pin drop a mile away. Everything has become incredibly quiet, with no wind and no sounds at all, other than any sounds that she makes when she moves. And there are no street lights, there's no other artificial light. So the only light here is the light from the stars, from the aurora. And she has this feeling almost like she can hear the aurora moving. And after many days of traveling, passing through the North Pole, traveling on beyond the North Pole, she eventually starts to see the occasional tree, and then a few more trees and a bit more life. And she continues to travel to a small town. And this is as far as she can go with her snowmobile. So she leaves her snowmobile at this town. She takes her inflatable raft off the back of the snowmobile. She inflates that with air. She puts her belongings into the raft. And she has to row across a few miles to the next bit of land. And in the morning, she sets off and starts rowing across that bit of ocean. And she's pleased with how calm everything is, how calm the wind is, how calm the ocean is. Just hearing the sloshing of the water against the underside of the raft. That scooping sound as she rows through the water. And she thinks to herself about how thick that water feels with those oars. That this cold water feels quite thick to push through. And she quite likes that fresh sea smell that this ice-cold water produces. And as she moves further away from the shore into that still water, she notices the back of a whale and hears the out-breath of that whale and can smell that slight fish smell from that whale just slightly off in the distance. And she watches as the whale seems to swim closer, turns slightly on its side as if to investigate her. dives down under the boat, pops up the other side, swims off a little way, before diving down out of sight. And she notices just stillness again. And looking around, there's the light blue sky, an almost perfectly reflective ocean. And then suddenly, halfway between her and the horizon, she sees that whale leap up out of the water, turn sideways and splash down into the water. And a little while later, she sees it pop its head up and then back down again. And she watches with interest as she continues to row, watching that whale. Then she sees another whale join it. And she thinks to herself that she bets that under the water now there'd be that whale song, which she finds so relaxing. And she continues to row towards the shore. And when she eventually reaches the shore, it's a rocky shore with a pine forest, a dense pine forest, going almost all the way to the water's edge. And the water's so calm, it's just lapping incredibly gently on the stones at the edge of the shore. She rows that raft up onto the shore so that she can jump out of the front of the raft and pull it up onto the shore even further. She then takes all her stuff out of the raft and starts letting that raft down. And she has to make the rest of this journey on foot. So she needs to take the time to let that raft down fully, to make it as small, as compact as possible. And she only has limited supplies on her for this last leg of her journey. She has a backpack that's almost as large as she is. And the raft is attached to the bottom of that backpack, the oars to the sides, and the backpack fits so comfortably and is weighted just right that she feels very comfortable walking with that backpack on her back. And she pushes through the pine forest. She's been rowing hard for most of the day. So what she wants to do is find a bit of a clearing so that she can set up a camp and rest for the night. And so as she pushes through that pine forest, she can hear the birds in the forest, hear the rustling leaves, hear each of her footsteps. She can smell that pine smell. And she pushes through until she finds a clearing. And in the clearing, she sets up her tent. She sets up her stove. She relaxes in that tent just sitting in the entrance of the tent. She makes herself some food and some drink, and watches as the sun sets and the most beautiful night sky appears, arching over the pine forest. And there's far less snow here, and yet it's still really cold. And after eating some food and drink, and relaxing for a bit, just enjoying the view, she tucks herself into her tent, closes the tent, and just relaxes in that tent, beginning to drift and float comfortably asleep. And as she drifts off asleep, so she has the most beautiful dreams, the most calming and relaxing dreams. And during the night, she awakens once or twice, and in the morning, she awakens feeling so refreshed, so peaceful. She leaves the tent, has something to eat and drink, packs that tent away. She takes a moment to look around at where she'd camped for the night, to take a proper look at this area, at this tiny meadowy area with hardy plants and grasses and the pine forest circling this area. And she then just looks at the direction she has to travel and continues her journey. And she travels down out of this area back into the pine forest. She knows this is the last leg of her journey to make it through this pine forest to a nearby town. And she set off from another pine forest days earlier. She's travelled up to the North Pole, through the North Pole, crossed the ocean, and is now travelling through this pine forest to get to her destination. And she's looking forward to arriving at that destination, looking forward to completing her trek. And as she makes this final bit of trek, so she finds her mind wandering to different elements of the experience, different things she's had to overcome, achieve, times she's had to push on, even when she'd want to quit. She focused on her strengths, what she's been proud of during this journey. And as this day draws to an end, so in the distance she can see the lights of a small town, and this spurs her on to keep going for this last leg of the journey. And as she arrives at that town, she's struck by how beautiful this town is. She thinks it looks like a winter postcard, with the most beautiful lights in the dark. And she walks into that town. And she finds the hotel in this town where she's due to check in. She checks in at that hotel, places all her belongings down in the room. The first thing she thinks is about how warm this room is, that she hadn't really noticed how cold she had been. She'd been comfortable, but didn't realize that she was still cold compared to being in this room, which had a real log fire in the corner, crackling away. She could feel that warmth of the fire on her cheeks. She could feel her cheeks going red with that warmth. She warmed her hands, warmed her feet, and sat down for a little while in her room before heading down, heading to a nearby restaurant, grabbing something to eat, and eating a proper meal for the first time in days, and really savouring that meal, and having a drink with that meal, really savouring that drink, and appreciating what she was eating and drinking, being proud of herself for her accomplishments. And she contacts people, lets them all know she's okay, she's made it to the destination. But what she's really doing is looking forward to going to bed, to sleeping in a proper bed for the first time in days. She knows that she's going to be collected and taken home in a couple of days' time. So for now, she decides to enjoy the experience of being in that hotel, that comfortable room, the great food, and just exploring this town. And so she goes to bed, rests down in that bed, feels how comfortable that real bed is compared to lying on something solid for the last few days, sinking her head comfortably into the pillow, and the warmth of that room. And she drifts and floats, comfortably and relaxed, asleep.